Hello dear students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. D.C. Saxena, Professor and Head of the Department of Food Engineering and Technology at Sant Longowal Institute of Engineering and Technology, Longowal. I am here to present the paper, Technology of Meat, Poultry, Fish and Seafood Products. Now the present module will be about the canning of meat as one of the basic preparatory procedure of meat. And this module will be explained to you further by my co-author, Mrs. Aarti.
Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I'm Khan Nadia from Sant Longowal Institute of Engineering and Technology on behalf of Ms. Aarti. Today, I'm going to talk about module 13 of paper number 8, Technology of Meat, Poultry, Fish and Seafood. In this module, we will be learning about canning of meat. Canning is a method of preserving food in which food contents are processed and sealed in an airtight container. Canning provides a shelf life typically ranging from 1 to 5 years. Although under specific circumstances, it can be much longer. A freeze-dried canned product such as canned dried lentils could last as long as 30 years in an edible state. Nicholas Eppert is known as the father of canning. In canning of meat, small cans or jars are best. All meats and poultry for canning should be slaughtered and handled in a strictly sanitary manner. Unless the meat is to be canned immediately, it's necessary to chill the carcass after slaughtering. Otherwise, decomposition will start within a few hours. During storage, after canning, there can be a loss of thiamine of as much as 30% depending on length of time, and at higher storage temperatures, there can be a reduction in protein quality. In principle, losses in canning are somewhat higher than in wet cooking because of the higher temperatures, utensils of enamelware, aluminium retained metal or stainless steel metal are best for meat canning. In this module, we will learn about the canned meat like safe and quality canned meat, canning of chicken or rabbit meat, canning of ground or chopped meat, canning of strips, cubes or chunks of meat, canning of meat stock which is broth, canning of chicken or turkey, canning of clams, canning of king and dungans, crab meat, canning of smoked fish, canning of tuna fish, safety checklist for canning. Canning is a method of preserving of foods. Small cans or jars are best for canning meat. All meats and poultry for canning should be slaughtered and handled in a strictly sanitary manner. Unless the meat is to be canned immediately, it's necessary to chill the carcass after slaughtering. Otherwise, decomposition will start within a few hours. Chilling makes little difference in the tenderness or flavor of meat after it's canned. But raw meat is so much easier to handle after chilling that most people prefer to chill it before canning. Meat that's kept thoroughly chilled may be held a short time before canning if that is more convenient. General procedures for canning. Use regular canning jars no larger than the size stated in the canning directions for the specific food being canned. Use self-sealing lids and screw bands. Mayonnaise type jars are not recommended for use in a pressure canner because they often break. After filling jars with food, release air bubbles by inserting a flat plastic spatula between the food and the jar. Adjust the head space and clean the jar rim with a dampened paper towel. Place the lid sealing compound down onto the clean jar rim. Jars with unclean rims may not seal. Fit the metal screw band over the lid. Follow the manufacturer's guidelines and close with or on the box to tighten the screw bands properly. Follow manufacturer's directions for use during can pressurizing, particularly the instructions for chucking the canner before and during use so you know how to respond to the hissing, jiggling or rocking of the weighted gauge. Cool the jars at room temperature for 12 to 24 hours. Racks or towels will minimize heat damage to counters. The food level and liquid volume of raw packed jars will noticeably lower after cooling because air is exhausted during processing and food shrinks. If a jar loses liquid during processing, do not open it to add more liquid. Reprocessing. If a lid fails to seal on a jar, refrigerate or freeze the contents or reprocess within 24 hours of the first processing. To reprocess, remove the lid and check the jar sealing surface for tiny nicks. If necessary, change the jar, add a new properly prepared lid and reprocess using the same processing time. Alternatively, adjust the head space in unsealed jars to 1.5 inch and freeze. Another option is to store single unsealed jars in a refrigerator and consume the contents within several days. Storage. Store jars in a cool, dark, dry place. For best quality and nutritive value, use within 1 year. Exposure to heat, freezing temperatures, or light decreases the quality and shelf life of canned food. Canned food stored in indirect sunlight or near warm places like hot pipes, range, or furnaces may lose some of its quality in a few weeks or months depending on the temperature. General tips for safe and quality canned meat. Check dial gauge on pressure canners annually. Use only good quality poultry, red meat and game for canning. Chill meat soon after slaughter to 40 degrees Fahrenheit or lower to keep it from spoiling. If you are not able to can the meat within a few days of slaughter, freeze it, keep frozen until ready to can it, and then thaw in a refrigerator. Keep all work areas sanitary and meat clean. Trim gristle, bruised spots and fat off meat before canning. Vent the pressure canner for 10 minutes before starting the canning process. meat products suitable for canning. Practically all processed meat products which require heat treatment during preparation for consumption are suitable for heat preservation. Meat products which do not receive any form of heat treatments before being consumed, such as dried meat, raw hams, or dry sausages, are naturally not suitable for canning as they are preserved by low pH or low water activity. The following groups of meat products are frequently manufactured as canned products: cooked hams or pork shoulders, sausage with brine of the Frankfurter type, sausage mix of the Bologna or liver sausage type, meat preparations such as corned beef, chopped pork, ready-to-eat dish with meat ingredients such as beef in gravy, chicken with rice, soups with meat ingredients such as chicken soup, oxtail soup. Canning of chicken or rabbit meat. Choose freshly killed and dressed animal. Large chickens are more flavorful than freshers. Chilled-dressed chicken 6 to 12 hours before canning. Soak dressed rabbits 1 hour in water containing 1 tablespoon of salt per quart and then rinse. Remove excess fat. Cut the chicken or rabbit into suitable sizes for canning. Can with or without bone. Type of pack. There are two types of pack: hot pack and raw pack. For hot pack, boil, steam or bake meat until about 2/3 is done. Add 1 teaspoon salt per quart if desired for taste. Fill jars with pieces and hot broth, leaving 1/4 inch head space. Raw pack. Add 1 teaspoon salt per quart if desired for taste. Fill jars loosely with raw meat pieces, leaving 1 1/4 inch head space. Do not add liquid. Wipe jar rims with a dampened clean paper towel. Adjust lids and process according to table 1 or 2. Canning of ground or chopped meat. Ground or chopped meat like bear, beef, lamb, pork, sausage, veal, venison. Choose fresh chilled meat with venison. Add 1 part high quality pork fat to 3 or 4 parts venison before grinding. Use freshly made sausage seasoned with salt and cayenne pepper. Sake may cause a bitter of flavor. Shape chopped meat into patties or balls, or cut cased sausage into 3 to 4 inch lengths. Cook until lightly browned. Ground meat may be sorted without shaping. Remove excess fat. Fill jars with pieces. Add boiling meat broth, tomato juice or water, leaving 1 inch head space. Canning of strips, cubes or chunks of meat. Choose quality chilled meat. Remove excess fat. Soak strong flavored wild meats for 1 hour in brine water containing 1 tablespoon of salt per quart. Rinse and remove large bone. Type of packing. Hot pack. Pre-cook meat until rare by roasting, stewing or browning in a small amount of fat. Add 1 teaspoon of salt per quart to the jar if desired for taste. Fill jars with pieces and add boiling broth, meat drippings, water or tomato juice, leaving 1 inch head space. Draw pack. Add 1 teaspoon of salt per quart to the jar if desired for taste. Fill jars with raw meat pieces, leaving 1 inch head space. Do not add liquid. Wipe jar rims with a dampened clean paper towel. Adjust lids and process according to table 1 or 2. Let's talk about meat stock, that's broth. For preparation of beef, saw or crack fresh trimmed beef bones to release their flavor. Rinse bones and place in a large stock pot or kettle. Cover bones with water. Cover pot and simmer for 3 to 4 hours. Remove bones, cool broth and pick off the meat. Skim off fat, add meat removed from bones to the broth and reheat to boiling. Fill jars, leaving 1 inch head space. Wipe jar rims with a dampened clean paper towel. Canning of chicken or turkey. Chicken or turkey. Place large carcass bones in a large stock pot. Cover bones with water. Cover pot and simmer for 30 to 45 minutes or until meat can be easily stripped from bones. Remove bones and pieces. Cool broth. Strip meat from bones. Remove and discard excess fat and return meat to broth. Reheat to boiling and fill jars, leaving 1 inch head space. Wipe jar rims with a dampened clean paper towel. Canning of clams. Keep clams live on ice until ready to can. Scrub shells thoroughly and rinse. Steam 5 minutes and open. Remove clam meat. Collect and save clam juice. Wash clam meat in water containing 1 teaspoon of salt per quart. Rinse and cover clam meat with boiling water containing 2 tablespoons of lemon juice or 1/2 teaspoon of citric acid per gallon. Boil 2 minutes and drain. To make minced clams, grind clams with a meat grinder or food processor. Fill hot jars loosely with pieces and add hot clam juice and boiling water if needed, leaving 1 inch head space. Remove air bubbles and adjust head space if needed. Wipe rims of jars with a dampened clean paper towel, adjust lids and process. Canning of king and Dungans crab meat. Keep live crabs on ice until ready to can. Wash crabs thoroughly using several changes of cold water. Simmer crabs 20 minutes in water contain cup of lemon juice and 2 tablespoons of salt per gallon. Cool in cold water, drain, remove back shell, then remove meat from body and claws. Soak meat 2 minutes in cold water containing 2 cups of lemon juice and 4 cups of white vinegar and 2 tablespoons of salt per gallon. Drain and squeeze crab meat to remove excess moisture. Fill hot 1/2 pint jars with 6 ounces of crab meat and pin jars with 12 ounces, leaving 1 inch head space. Add 1/2 teaspoon of citric acid or 2 tablespoons of lemon juice to each 1/2 pin jar, or 1 teaspoon of citric acid or 4 tablespoons of lemon juice per pin jar. Cover with fresh boiling water, leaving 1 inch head space. Remove air bubbles and adjust head space if needed. Wipe rims of jars with a dampened clean paper towel, adjust lids and process. Canning of fish in pin jars. If the fish is frozen, thaw it in the refrigerator before canning. Rinse the fish in cold water. You can add vinegar to the water to help remove slime. Remove head, tail, fin, and scales. It's not necessary to remove the skin. You can leave the bones in most fish because the bones become very soft and are a good source of calcium. For halibut, remove the head, tail, fins, skin, and the bones. Wash and remove all blood. Refrigerate all fish until you are ready to pack in jars. Split fish lengthwise if desired. Cut clean fish into 3/2 inch length. If the skin has been left on the fish, pack the fish skin out for a nicer appearance or skin in for easier jar cleaning. Fill hot pin jars, leaving 1 inch head space. Add 1 tablespoon of salt per pint if desired. Do not add liquids. Carefully clean the jar rims with a clean damp paper towel. Wipe with a dry paper towel to remove any fish oil. Adjust lids and process. Fish in 1/2 pint or 12 ounce jars would be processed for same amount of time as pint jars. Canning of smoked fish. If smoked fish has been frozen, thaw in refrigerator until no ice crystals remain before canning. If not done prior to smoking, cut fish into pieces that will fit vertically into pint canning jars, leaving 1 inch head space. Pack smoked fish vertically into hot jars, leaving 1 inch head space between the pieces and the top rim of the jar. The fish may be packed either loosely or tightly. Do not add liquid to the jars. Clean jar rims with a clean damp paper towel. Adjust lids and process. Caution: lightly smoked fish is recommended for canning because the smoke flavor will become stronger and the flesh drier after processing. However, because it has not yet been cooked, do not taste lightly smoked fish before canning. Follow these recommended canning instructions carefully. Use a 16 to 22 quart pressure canner for this procedure. Do not use small pressure saucepans. Say processing times have not been determined. Do not use jars larger than 1 pint. 1/2 pints could be safely processed for the same length of time as pints, but the quality of the product may be less acceptable. Canning of tuna fish. Keep tuna on ice until ready to can. Remove Vistra and wash fish well in cold water. Allow blood to drain from stomach cavity. Place fish belly down on a rack or metal tray in the bottom of a large baking pan. Cut tuna in a half crosswise if necessary. Pre-cook fish by baking at 250 degree Fahrenheit for 2.5 to 4 hours, depending on size, or at 350 degree Fahrenheit for 1 hour. The fish may also be cooked in a steamer for 2 to 4 hours. If a thermometer is used, cook to 165 degree to 175 degree Fahrenheit internal temperature. Refrigerate cooked fish overnight to firm the meat. Peel off the skin with a knife, removing blood vessels and any discolored flesh. Cut meat away from bones. Cut out and discard all bones, fin bases and dark flesh quarter. Cut quarters crosswise into lengths suitable for half pint or pint jars. Fill into hot jars, pressing down gently to make a solid pack. Tuna may be packed in water or oil, whichever is preferred. Add water or oil to jars, leaving 1 inch headspace. Remove air bubbles and adjust headspace if needed. Add 1/2 teaspoon of salt per half pint or 1 teaspoon of salt per pint if desired. Carefully clean the jar rims with a clean, damp paper towel. Wipe with a dry paper towel to remove any fish oil. Adjust lids and process. Now, I will tell you some of the safety rules for canning. Follow directions exactly for filling jars. Overpacked jars do not heat as evenly as correctly packed jars. Always can meats in a pressure canner. Boiling water canners or steamers do not produce temperatures high enough to kill botulism causing bacteria and other spoilage organisms. Never can in an oven, whether electric, gas, wood burning or microwave oven. Be sure the pressure canner dial gauge is accurate. Test it once a year or more often if you do a great deal of canning, or drop the lid. Each time you use a pressure canner, check to see that the petcock and safety valve are not blocked. Always exhaust air from a pressure canner for 10 minutes before letting pressure build. Increase pressure at altitudes above 1000 feet for weight gauge canners or 2000 feet for dial gauge canners to reach the temperature of 240 degree Fahrenheit for pressure canning. Never can meat products for which you do not have research processing times. A safe canning time cannot accurately be determined at home. For an extra guarantee of safety, boil home canned meats before eating them. At altitudes below 1000 feet, boil for 10 minutes. Add an additional minute of boiling time for each additional 1000 feet of elevation. Safety checklist for canning. Increase pressure at altitudes above 1000 feet for weighted gauge canners or 2000 feet for dial gauge canners to reach the proper temperature, that's 240 degree Fahrenheit for pressure canning. Never can meat products for which you do not have research processing times. a safe canning time cannot accurately be determined at home. For an extra guarantee of safety, boil home canned meats before eating them. At altitudes below 1000 feet, boil for 10 minutes. Add an additional minute of boiling time for each 1000 feet of elevation. Recommended process times for a dial gauge pressure canner. Here we have type of meat, then type of pack, jar size, and process time. For chicken or rabbit without bones, type of pack used is hot or raw. Jar size will be pints with process time 75 minutes and quarts with process time 90 minutes. Again, pints for hot or raw with process time 65 minutes, then quarts with process time 75 minutes. Then Kyle Cone Cane, hot packs with pints and process time 75 minutes. For ground or chopped meat, whether hot or raw, jar size is pints or quarts with process times of 75 minutes and 90 minutes. For strips, cubes or chunks of meat, which are type of pack is hot, and jar size are pints with 75 minute process time and quarts with 90 minute processing time. Meat stock or broth, which may be hot, and jar size is pints or quarts with 20 minute and 25 minute processing time. For mince meat, type of pack is hot and jar size is quarts with 90 minutes process time. For soups, jar size is pints or quarts with process time of 60 minutes and 75 minutes. For fish, type of pack is raw and the jar size is pints with 100 minute process time and quarts with 160 minute process time. Recommended process times for weighted gauge pressure canner. First is chicken or rabbit without bones. Type of pack for this is hot or raw and the jar size are pints with process time 75 minutes and quarts with process time 90 minutes. And chicken or rabbit with bone, type of pack is hot. Jar size is again pints or quarts with process time of 65 minutes and 75 minutes. For Kyle, Cone and Cane, type of pack is hot and jar size is pints with process time of about 75 minutes. For ground or chopped meat, type of pack is hot with jar size pint and quarts with a process time of 75 and 90 minutes. For strip, cubes or chunks of meat, whether hot or raw, size of jar is pint, quart, 75 and 90 minute process time. For meat stock or broth, type of pack is hot and jar size is pints and quarts with 75 and 90 minutes processing time. For mince meat, type of pack is hot and jar size will be pints or quarts with a process time of 20 minutes and 25 minutes. For soups, type of pack will be hot and jar size is quarts with a process time of 90 minutes. For fish, type of pack is raw and the jar size is pints with 60 minute process time, quarts with 75 minute process time, again pints with 100 minute process time, and then quarts with 150 minute process time. Canning makes for a better distribution of meat supply throughout the year. Frozen meat may be canned, but it does not make a high quality product. Do not thaw frozen meat. Utensils of enamelware, aluminium, retained metal, or stainless steel metal are best for meat canning. Meat may take up harmful quantities of zinc from galvanized iron if allowed to remain in contact with it for more than 30 minutes. Copper and iron utensils may cause the canned meat to be discolored. wooden surfaces are difficult to clean. Plain tin cans and glass jars are satisfactory for meat canning. Enamel-lined tin cans are not satisfactory for meat, especially chicken, since they are likely to peel off and discolor the meat. This discoloration, while unattractive, is harmless. Small cans or jars are best for canning meat. The most suitable sizes are number 2 and number 2% tin cans and pint glass jars number 3. Tin cans and quart glass jars are not recommended because of much heavier processing necessary. Have cans or jars and the lids clean and in good condition. Discard any jars or caps showing cracks, chips, or dents, or lids with loose linings. Discard corroded tin cans. Wash cans, jars, and screw lids with soapy water and rinse in clear water. Self-sealing jar caps and tin can lids should be kept dry and be wiped carefully. Dip rubber rings into boiling water before using. So, students, let us now summarize what we have learned in this module. Canning makes for better distribution of meat supply throughout the year. Frozen meat may be canned, but it does not make a high quality product. Canning operations must be performed only by fully trained personnel. Utensils of enamelware, aluminium retained metal, or stainless steel metal are best for canning. Small cans or jars are also best for canning of meat. Discard any jars or caps showing cracks, chips, or dents, or lids with loose linings. Discard corroded tin cans also. Some general tips for safe and quality canned meat are: first, check dial gauges on pressure canners annually. Use only good quality poultry, red meat, and game for canning. Chill meat soon after slaughter to 40 degree Fahrenheit or lower to keep it from spoiling. If you are not able to can the meat within a few days of slaughter, freeze it. Keep frozen until ready to can it, and then thaw in a refrigerator. Keep all work areas sanitary and meat clean. Trim gristle, bruised spots, and fat off meat before canning. Vent the pressure canner for 10 minutes before starting the canning process. Thank you.
Now you have the knowledge of canning of meat, how it is being done, what are the different aspects of canning of meat, which comes under basic preparatory procedure of meat, explained by my co-author. Now, in the next module, you will be given the knowledge of technology of sausages as well as comminuted meat products. Thank you.